Hey class, hi, hello, namaste, adabar, sat sri akal, assalamu alaikum, vanakkam and khambagadi to all of you. Welcome to today's session. As you all know, today's class is your Umang series for your grade 9 and we are discussing the session 2 of your topic lines and angles. As I've told you, now since we have started the geometry section, it is very important for you to revise the previous session and be regular here, because geometry section students find it difficult compared to the algebra part, right? So I want your full response over here. I want you to be more active during these classes and practice more and more problems and try to cover the NCERT along with you. Okay, so as I was saying, today we will be doing the session 2 for your topic lines and angles. So in the first session, we have talked about intersecting and non-intersecting lines and pair of angles. Okay, that is what we have talked about. Now, today's session we will be talking about parallel lines and a transversal line. Today's class will be talking about parallel lines and a transversal line. So beta, first let's look at the question, homework question, which I have given you in the last class. So the homework question is, find the measure of an angle which is 26 degree more than its complement. So there is one angle, okay, it is 26 degree more than its complementary angle. So let us say the angle is x. I will say what will be its complement. Since we know complementary angle sum is 90 degree, so if one angle is x, other will be, its complementary angle will be 90 minus x, right? So if my angle is x, its complementary will become 90 minus x. I know my angle is 26 degree more than its complement, so if I subtract my angle from its complementary angle, the answer should be 26. That is what saying, the angle is 26 degree more than its complement. So solve this, x minus 90, minus into minus is plus x is equal to 26. Shift minus 90 over there, so 2x is equal to, what are you getting? 116. So x is equal to 116 divided by 2, which is equal to what? 5 and 8, 58. So what is my angle? My angle is 58 degree, and what will be its complement, beta? Its complement will be 32 degree. And you can see, if you will find out the difference between these two, you will say ki haan sir, the difference is 26 degree. So actually they are asking you find the measure of that angle. So answer will be, the angle is 58 degree, because 58 is 26 more than its complement. Now, I would like to tell you the names of those students who have given the correct answer. Okay. So, many of you have given the answer. So, I will just tell you some of the names. The one who has given the correct answers very quickly. Okay. So, Vishwa was the first one to give the correct answer, homework answer, 58 degree. After that, I have got the second answer from Arjun. Okay, then Lakshya beta, the answer is not 32, the answer is 58, because the angle should be 26 degree more than the complement. So 32 will not be considered correct. You have just done the opposite, you have made the equation opposite. Okay, so that 32 is not actually correct answer. Correct answer is 58 degree. Okay, then Jyoti has given the correct answer, Harry Potter has given the correct answer, and then who else is here? 32, I'm saying you again, is not the correct answer, because 32 is 26 degree less than the complement, not more. 58 is the correct answer, because 58 is 26 degree more than its complement. Okay, Vilas has also written both the values. Rajesh has given the correct answer, Ratnesh and Rajesh, Nirla, who else? I can see many of you has given me 116 also. 116, I think you have mistaken it for the supplementary question, right? That they are supplementary. So remember, complementary means sum is 90, supplementary means sum is 180 degree. Got it? So these are some of the students who have given the correct answer. Many of you have mistaken it with the 32 degree, so that is not correct. Okay, you have made the equation wrong. Manasi also has given the correct answer. Game of Studies, Prabhat, Siddharth, and Supriya. Okay, so these are some of the names which have done it correctly. Okay, so very well done. Now, let's move ahead and let's talk about parallel lines and a transversal line. First thing, what are parallel lines? Parallel lines are the lines that never cross and are always at the same distance apart. So, bhai, I have told you in the last class also, parallel lines will never intersect and the distance between them will be same everywhere. Okay, that is called parallel lines. Now, understand what is called a transversal line. What is called a transversal line? So, a transversal line, understand carefully. If you have two or more lines, if I have two or more lines, suppose here I have L1 and L2. If I draw a line in such a way that the line will intersect L1 and L2 at different points. It should intersect L1 at different points. It should intersect L2 at different points. Then it will be called a transversal line. So a line which intersect two or more lines at distinct points is called transversal. Suppose if more lines, suppose these three lines are given here. If I draw a line like this, so you can clearly see there are three lines and the line which I have drawn is intersecting these three lines at three different points. So I can say it is transversal to all. For example, if I have two lines like this, if I draw a line over here, then you can see ki haan sir, this line is intersecting both the lines at two different points. So it will be a transversal. But if I draw a line, suppose from here, now you will see that this line is intersecting both the lines at same point. It is not intersecting at distant points. So you will say it is not transversal. It is what? It is not transversal. Got it? So this is how you will find out the difference between transversal and not transversal. Whatever number of lines are there, the transversal will intersect all those lines at different points. At different points. So that is called a transversal line. Got it? Now, whenever a transversal line intersect two lines, okay, total 8 angles are formed. As you can see, angle 1, 2, 3, 4, similarly 5, 6, 7, and 8. So total 8 angles are formed when a transversal line passes through two lines. When a transversal line passes through two lines. So now in this chapter, in this session, we are going to study the relationship between these angles. Okay. So again, if the lines are parallel, still a transversal can pass through it because it is going through two different, it is intersecting both the lines at two different points. Now again here we have got four angles. You can see here angle 1, angle 2, angle 3, angle 4. Okay, here angle 5, angle 6, angle 7, and angle 8. Correct? These are your 8 angles formed. So let's understand the relationship between them. So beta, first thing yaad rakhna, if these are your two transversal lines. If these are your two parallel lines and this is your transversal line over here, as you can see, this is your transversal line over here. Okay, the black one is your transversal line. So you can clearly see that these angles are formed in the inner part. These four angles are present on the inner front. So these four angles which are inside the parallel lines, they are called interior angles, and these four angles which are outside, as you can see, they are on the outer part, they will be called exterior angle. Okay, so interior are the inner ones. So these four will be called your interior, and what will be your exterior? Your exterior will be these outer one. Dekho, dikh raha hai na logic? Interior one and outer exterior one. Okay, so these are your interior angles and exterior angles. Now understand the corresponding angles. The angles in matching corners are called corresponding angles. Matching corner means what, beta? Ki bhai, we know there are 8 angles. So in this first part, if I have an angle here, So at the same place in the bottom side, there are angle, one more angle is here. So these two angles are corresponding to each other. If I take one angle here, so at the same place, we have one more angle here. So these two are corresponding. Then we have one angle over here. And at the same place, we have one more angle here. So these two are corresponding. And then we have one angle over here and one angle over here. So these two will be called corresponding. So you can see in a way that there are four angles here. Right? 1, 2, 3, and 4. So similarly, on the same part, whatever angles are at the same position, that means this part, these four angles are available over here. These four angles, if you cut it in the middle, okay. For example, if I have this diagram over here, let's say it is A, B, C, D, okay, and here I have E, F, G, and H. If this is my diagram, in this case, how do you find out that which one is the corresponding part? So what you do, beta, you cut this diagram in the middle from here. Okay, cut this diagram in the middle from here and paste it on the top of that. So you will see that A and E will coincide. B and F will coincide. C and G will coincide. And D and H will coincide. Right? Exactly. So those coinciding ones will be called your corresponding angles. Now, what is the property of corresponding angle? The property is, suppose I will make a bigger diagram so that it is clearly visible to you. Okay, let's say A, B, C, D, E, F, G, and H. So the corresponding angles property, it is, what are the corresponding angles? That when two lines are intersected by a transversal, so how many pairs of corresponding angles you are getting? One is angle A and angle E. The other pair is angle B and angle F. The other pair is angle C and angle G. The other pair is angle D and angle H. So these are your pairs of corresponding angles. Okay. What? They are pairs of corresponding angle. So if there are two parallel lines, you will get four pairs of corresponding angle. And the relationship here, the most important thing, the relationship here is that if two lines are parallel, remember, if two lines are parallel, pair of corresponding angles formed are equal. Pair of corresponding angles formed are equal. That means angle A and angle E will be equal, angle B and angle F will be equal, angle C and angle G will be equal, angle D and angle H will be equal. So better this corresponding angles, it is an axiom. It is an axiom, so we know it is true. Okay, you will not have any proof for it. So corresponding angles, we have taken it as true, and now all the pair of angles, we will prove them to be true now. Okay, so corresponding angles is taken as true. Corresponding angles are taken as true. That is an axiom. So corresponding angles axioms, what does it say? Is that if two parallel lines are intersected by a transversal line, so the pair of corresponding angles formed are equal. Pair of corresponding angles formed are equal. Now, there is a converse also. There is a converse of this as well. Converse of corresponding angles axiom. The converse says, beta, suppose if I have a diagram like this. Let's say this is angle 7, this angle is 75 degree and this angle is 75 degree. As you can clearly see that I don't know whether the lines are parallel or not. Okay, we don't know whether L and M, these lines are parallel or not. We don't know about it. But they have given that the pair of corresponding angles formed are equal. So the axiom says if pair of corresponding angles formed are equal, pair of corresponding angles formed are equal, then lines will be parallel. The lines will be parallel. It means, dekho, the axiom is just opposite of it. Then I can say the lines are parallel. So, in the corresponding angle axiom, what we have learned, that if the lines are parallel, corresponding angles are equal. And in the converse, we just say opposite of it, that if the corresponding angles are equal, lines will be parallel. Got it? So the converse will tell you that the, whether the lines are given parallel or not. So just if two lines are parallel, if two lines are parallel, corresponding angles formed are equal. If it is given that the lines are parallel, corresponding angles formed are equal. But if they give that corresponding angles formed are equal, then opposite also you can say that the lines will be parallel. So it works vice versa. Lines are parallel, corresponding angles are equal. If corresponding angles are equal, lines will be parallel. So that is the converse and the theorem. Okay, so that is your corresponding angles. Now let's come to the second part, which is your alternate interior angle. For alternate interior angle, now, just understand this Z formation. There is this Z formation. First thing, understand, it is talking about interior angles. It is talking about interior angles. So we know there are only four interior angles. That too, it is talking about alternate. Alternate means opposite, different sides, you know, one and the other. So there were four interior angles. If you remember, there were four interior angles. So we want interior angles and on the opposite side. So it means that suppose if I choose one interior angle over here, one interior angle over here I have chosen. So now the other should be the opposite part. So on, if one is on the left side, the other should be on the right hand side. So on the right hand side, the interior angle present is this. One is at the top, the other is at the bottom. Okay, so this is called your interior consecutive angle. And as I was telling you, Z formation, see, here it is your Z formation. In this way, you will say, sir, this is also an interior angle. So opposite angle for this, it is on the right side, I will go for the left. It is at the top, I will go for the bottom. So these two are a pair of interior consecutive angles. Alternate interior angle. These two are a pair of interior alternate angle. So beta, yaad rakhna, again I am showing you the diagram here. Let's say this is your angle A. Let's say this is your B. Let's say this is your C. And let's say this is your D. Okay. So if I choose, suppose angle A. So for it, the interior alternate angle will be what? First, interior means it should be inner, and alternate means opposite. So angle A is here. On the opposite side, we have angle C. So this will be forming your one pair of interior alternate angle, angle A and angle C. The other pair, if you want to talk about the other pair. So other pair, one, if I choose this angle, angle B. So the on the opposite side of angle B, we have angle D. And that to interior angle we are talking about. So angle B and angle D will be the other pair. Angle B and angle D. These are the two pairs of interior alternate angle. These are your two pairs of interior alternate angle. Short form I am writing IAA. Interior alternate angles. That is what I am going to use as the short form now onwards. Interior alternate angles. Okay. Now the property is that if two lines are parallel. The property is if two lines are parallel, that L and M, these two lines are given. If L is parallel to M, if two parallel lines are intersected by a transversal line, if two parallel lines are intersected by a transversal line, then I can say interior alternate angles formed will also be equal. Then I will say interior alternate angles formed are also equal. So remember, two parallel lines. If L and M are not parallel, then you cannot say they are equal. If L and M are not parallel, then you cannot say they will be equal. If they are parallel, then only I can say that the pair of interior alternate angles will be equal and the pair of corresponding angles will also be equal. Okay. So this is your interior alternate, that if two parallel lines are intersected by a transversal line, then pair of इंटीरियर ऑल्टरनेट एंगल्स फॉर्म विल बी इक्वल, पेयर ऑफ इंटीरियर ऑल्टरनेट एंगल्स फॉर्म्ड विल बी इक्वल, करेक्ट. नाउ अंडरस्टैंड द नेक्स्ट पार्ट, दैट हाउ डू वी प्रूव इट, बिकॉज नाउ ऑनवर्ड्स इट इज थियरम, सो यू शुड नो द प्रूफ. द प्रूफ्स आर वेरी इजी, ट्रस्ट मी, द प्रूफ्स आर वेरी इजी. लेट्स से दिस इज योर लाइन एल एंड योर लाइन एम, दे आर इंटरसेक्टेड बाय अ ट्रांसवर्सल लाइन. एल एंड एम आर पैरेलल, लेट्स से दे बोथ आर पैरेलल. हियर यू हैव ए बी सी एंड डी, ओके, दैट इज वॉट वी नो, राइट. हाँ, ओके सर, तो हाउ डू यू प्रूव दैट एंगल ए एंड एंगल सी आर इक्वल, और हाउ डू यू प्रूव दैट एंगल बी एंड एंगल डी आर ऑल्सो इक्वल, हाउ डू यू प्रूव इट. तो बेटा देखो, आई विल प्रूव एनी वन, अदर सिमिलरली यू कैन प्रूव देम एज वेल. तो वी हैव जस्ट लर्नड अबाउट द करेस्पॉन्डिंग एंगल्स, वी हैव जस्ट लर्नड अबाउट द करेस्पॉन्डिंग एंगल्स. सो इन करेस्पॉन्डिंग एंगल्स, इन करेस्पॉन्डिंग एंगल्स बेटा वॉट हैपन्स, वी नो दैट इन केस ऑफ करेस्पॉन्डिंग एंगल्स द पेयर ऑफ करेस्पॉन्डिंग एंगल्स आर इक्वल इफ द लाइन्स आर पैरेलल. तो आई नो दैट एल इज पैरेलल टू एम, सो करेस्पॉन्डिंग एंगल्स विल बी इक्वल. So for this A, I will say my corresponding angle will be somewhere here at the same place. Let's say it is E, right? I can say that sir, angle A will be equal to angle E because of they are a pair of corresponding angle. Because they are a pair of corresponding angle. Second thing, that sir, this E and C should also be equal. Let me know why E and C will be equal. I have taught you yesterday. Why angle E will be equal to angle C? And I hope many of you are giving correct answer. So, dekho beta, bhai, they will be equal. They will be equal because of vertically opposite angles. Because of what? Because of vertically opposite angles. As simple as that. Right? So, angle A and angle E are equal because of corresponding pairs. Angle E and angle C are equal. So A is equal to E and E is equal to C. So from above equations, we can say that angle A will be equal to angle C. And similarly, you can prove for angle B is equal to angle D as well. Similarly, you can prove for angle B and angle D as well. Okay? So this is the proof for alternate interior angles are equal. Now in alternate interior angles or interior alternate angles, both are same thing. There lies a converse theorem as well. So in the converse theorem, beta, what will happen? In converse of interior alternate angles, what will happen? That if pair of interior alternate angles formed are equal, then lines will be parallel. So it is again the same thing. It is again the same thing. If I say, suppose if I give you a diagram like this, if I give you a diagram like this, let's say these are your two lines. We don't know whether they are parallel or not. And this is the transversal. I have told you, let us say this is 70 degree and this is also 70 degree. So what you can say about L and M? So you can clearly see that the pair of interior alternate angles formed are equal. So if they are equal, you can say L is parallel to M. Got it? So the interior alternate angle theorem says that if two lines are parallel, if two parallel lines are intersected by a transversal line, pair of interior alternate angles formed are equal. And the converse says that if pair of interior alternate angles formed are equal, then the lines will be parallel. Okay. So if lines are parallel, interior alternate angles are equal. If interior alternate angles are equal, lines will be parallel. So this is vice versa rule. Okay. So this will work for all the pairs which we are going to study now onwards. Okay. Now let's go for the next part, alternate exterior angle. So same thing. Ab dekho, again the same logic. First thing, it is exterior angle. So it will lie on the outside. Let us say I have chosen this exterior angle. Alternate means on the opposite side. So the other one will be here. If I choose the one exterior angle over here, So for this, the other one will be here. So these are the pair of alternate exterior angles. These are the pair of alternate exterior angles. So what happens with this? Suppose, let's say beta, it is A, it is B, and it is C, it is D. So for A, C is the pair. For B, D is the pair. Okay. Now remember, what does this theorem says? Alternate exterior angles. It says that if a pair of parallel lines are intersected by a transversal line. Okay. So this line L and M are parallel. So it says, sir, if L is parallel to M, if L is parallel to M, so we have learned till now corresponding angles are equal. Interior alternate angles are equal. Now exterior alternate angles, if the lines are parallel, the pair of exterior alternate angles formed are also equal. They are also considered to be what? They are also considered to be equal. ठीक है? तो याद रखना बेटा, corresponding angles equal, interior alternate equal, exterior alternate equal. Now how do you prove it? Proof के लिए बेटा, let us take this here angle one angle as E. I know that angle A will be equal to angle E because of vertically opposite angles, है ना? देख लो, X formation is over here. I have told you X formation. So when two lines are intersecting, vertically opposite angles are equal. So angle A is equal to angle E. Also, angle E and angle C are what? A pair of corresponding angle. So I can say, sir, angle E will be equal to angle C because they are corresponding angle. See, I am rewriting the reason every time. So angle A is equal to angle E is equal to angle C. So from these two, I can say angle A will be equal to angle C. And similarly, you can prove the result for angle B is equal to angle D. But the proof of these now is very basic, very small proofs. Okay, two line proofs are there. Okay, the proofs are all of two lines. Samajh lo, it is that easy. Okay, so this is your proof for exterior alternate angles. Now the converse, what will the converse says? The converse, again, it will say the same thing, that if the alternate exterior angles formed are equal. For example, here, let's say this is 120 degree and this is also 120 degree. So as you can clearly see, this is L, this is M. The exterior alternate angles formed are equal. Then I can say lines will be parallel. So all the converse theorem says the same thing. Corresponding angles axiom, if lines are parallel, corresponding angles are equal. Converse of corresponding angles axiom, if corresponding angles are equal, lines will be parallel. Interior alternate angle theorem, if the lines are parallel, interior alternate angles formed are equal. And the converse says, if the interior alternate angles formed are equal, the lines will be parallel. Okay, similarly for exterior alternate angles also, the theorem says that if lines are parallel, exterior alternate angles formed are equal. The converse says, if exterior alternate angles formed are equal, the lines will be parallel. So it goes vice versa, in both direction it goes. Okay, so this is for your converse of exterior alternate angle. Ab beta, now let's talk about the interior consecutive angles. Okay, interior angles on the same side of the transversal. So for example, if I choose this angle 3, if I choose this angle 3 as my interior angle, if I choose this angle 3 as my interior angle, now which other interior angle is there which is on the same side of the transversal? So you will clearly say this angle is here on the same side of the transversal, correct? Similarly, if I choose angle 4, then for angle 4, which angle do I have? I have angle 5, correct? So the interior consecutive angles, dekho, interior alternate, I have told you, interior means inner angles, alternate means opposite. Now, in interior consecutive angles, it means interior means the inner one, consecutive means same side. So the same side, interior angles on the same side are called interior consecutive angles. We will use the short form as ICA, interior consecutive angles. Interior consecutive angles. अब बेटा इसका proof ना is very important. तो याद रखना what happens here. If there are two lines which are parallel to each other, always remember parallel lines is must. So if they are parallel to each other, suppose if I choose here angle A and this is angle B, this is angle C, and let's say this is angle D. So for A, the interior consecutive angle. Consecutive means on the same side, interior means inner one. So A and D are consecutive. And here B and C, B and C are consecutive. Now till now we saw corresponding angles equal, alternate angles equal, exterior alternate angles equal, interior alternate angles equal. Now what happens for the consecutive angles? Yaad rakhna beta, consecutive angles are not equal. These are the only angles which are not equal. Instead their sum is 180 degree. Instead their sum is 180 degree. So if you have a pair of interior consecutive angles, if you have a pair of interior consecutive angles, you will see that their sum is 180 degree. Or you can say if two parallel lines are intersected by a transversal line. Okay, let me write the statement. If two parallel lines are intersected by a transversal line, then pair of interior consecutive angles formed are not equal, are supplementary. By supplementary means what? Their sum is equal to 180 degree. Yaad rakhna, it is very important. Consecutive angles are supplementary. Consecutive angles are supplementary. Now how do you prove it? Obviously, how do you prove it? So for proving it, let's look here. Let's say this is your angle A, angle B, angle C, angle D. I have to prove, angle A plus angle D is equal to 180 degree. Na? So what you will do, beta, the first thing I know, ki sir, if A, angle A is given here, I can say that sir, A will have a corresponding angle over here. Let's say E. So I know angle A and angle E will be equal. So I will say sir, first thing, angle A is equal to angle E because they will be corresponding angle. Now beta, look carefully at this DE. You will see this transversal is a straight line, and from this straight line there is a ray coming out of it. If I treat this point, there is a ray coming out of it, and these two angles D and E are forming a linear pair. So I can say angle D plus angle E will be equal to 180 degree because they are forming a linear pair. Now you know that angle E is also equal to angle A. So if I substitute the value of angle E from the first equation, I can say angle E is equal to angle A. So if I put angle E as angle A in this part, you will get angle D plus angle A is equal to 180 degree, or rearrange it, angle A plus angle D is equal to 180 degree. I have told you none of these proof is more than one or two lines. All the proofs are very easy. Okay, so this is your interior consecutive angles proof of interior consecutive angles proof. It is the proof of interior consecutive angles. Now the converse again here will be the same, that here beta, we knew that lines are parallel. L and M is given. It is given that lines are parallel. If lines are parallel, then only all these things will happen. The converse will be what? The converse will be very easy. Suppose if I give you a diagram like this, where this is let's say 60 degree, this is let's say 120 degree. So you will clearly see both are on the same side of the transversal and interior angle. And if you add them, you are getting 180 degree. So the converse is if interior consecutive angles formed are supplementary, if they are supplementary, then lines will be parallel. Lines will be what? Parallel. So if it is true, L and M, I can say that L will be parallel to M. So the converse theorem is used to prove that the lines are parallel, and the normal theorems are used to get the angles. Okay, so this is your interior consecutive angle. Now exterior consecutive angle is just opposite of it. You can easily get the idea for exterior consecutive angle. First, it should be an exterior angle. So let's say angle A. So for angle A, let's say angle B, angle C and angle D. First thing, they are exterior and consecutive. So for angle A, angle D outside, and for angle B, angle C outside. Okay, and in exterior consecutive angles also, the sum is equal to 180 degree. The sum is equal to 180 degree. Okay, and the converse of exterior consecutive angles will be again the same part, that if the pair of exterior consecutive angles formed are equal, then I can say that the lines will be parallel. Okay, so remember, it is all whatever we have learned, corresponding angles are equal, interior alternate angles are equal, exterior alternate angles are equal, interior consecutive are supplementary, exterior consecutive angles are supplementary. This all is true only if the lines are parallel. If the lines are not parallel, none of them will work. Okay, so remember, we are talking about the parallel lines. Its proof again you can do in the very easy manner. Same way, try to think about it, you will get the part. Okay, so try this proof of exterior consecutive angles, that they are also supplementary. Okay, now one more thing which we have already learned in your if you remember Euclid's geometry, we know beta. Suppose if I give you that line A is parallel to B, line A and B are parallel, and if I give you that line A is also parallel to C. So if A is parallel to B and A is parallel to C, so both B and C are parallel to the same line, I can say then from these two, you can say B will also be parallel to C. Okay, so lines which are parallel to the same line are parallel to each other. So both B and C are parallel to the same line A. So you can say that, sir, B will be parallel to C, as simple as that. Okay, now let's look at a question. So before I start the question, let me revise it for you. Corresponding angles equal, interior alternate angles equal, exterior alternate angles equal, interior consecutive supplementary, exterior consecutive supplementary angles. Okay, now let's look at the questions. Questions are very easy, trust me. Just identify the pair of angles. And vertically opposite angles for intersecting lines are what? Also equal. So beta, dekho, you have to find out the value of x and y. Understand, this question can be done in plenty of ways. Many ways you can solve it. So if I am doing it by some method, you are getting it by some another method, it doesn't mean that you have done it wrong or I have done it correct. It can be solved in many ways. It can be solved in many ways. One of the way, I can say that, sir, this angle x, one of the way I can say is that, sir, this angle x and this 130 degree both will be equal, because let me know what should be, which pair do they form. I will say that x is equal to 130 degree. Tell me what should be the reason for it. So you see here, x is on the bottom side, 130 is also at the same place. So they are forming corresponding angle. I hope many of you have given the correct answers. Correct, you have got the value of x. And then I can say y will also be equal to 130 degree. Which pair they are forming? They are forming a pair of vertically opposite angles. Batao, so easy. Two lines. Within two lines, you will get your answer. Now, you can do it in many ways also. You can do it like, ki sir, first I will say, ki sir, 50 plus x. You can also, alternative method, there are many methods. You can say, sir, x plus 50 should be equal to 180 degree, because you will say, ki sir, they are forming a linear pair. This x and 50 are forming a linear pair. So x is equal to 130. And then you can say, sir, x, angle x will be equal to angle y will be equal to 130. The reason you are writing it as interior alternate angle. Dekh lo, x and y are forming interior alternate angle. So in this case also, x and y both are again 130. So it can be solved in many ways. Don't be afraid. Answer should be correct. Okay, just follow the properties and try to recognize the pair of angles which are there. Okay, now let's move to the next part. If a transversal intersect two lines such that the bisector of a pair of corresponding angles are parallel, then prove that the two lines are parallel. So beta, dekho bhai what it is. Suppose if I have a line, a transversal is intersecting two lines. Remember, it is not saying whether these lines are parallel or not. So let us say it is L and M, and the transversal is intersecting it, such that the bisector of a pair of corresponding angles. So one pair of corresponding angle is there, its bisector. So bisector will be somewhere here. And for this angle, the corresponding angle is this one. So bisector of a pair of corresponding angles are parallel. Okay. So they have told that these two bisectors, what they have told? They have told that these two bisectors are parallel. The yellow lines are parallel to each other. Then prove that the two lines, that is L and M, are also parallel. Okay. So what we need to prove? To prove L is parallel to M. And they have given these two lines are parallel. Now, beta, dekho. If you think carefully, if these two lines are parallel, this transversal is acting as a transversal for them as well. For the yellow lines, it is also acting as a transversal. For the yellow lines also, it is acting as a transversal. Okay, so I can say, sir, this angle and this angle should be equal. So if it is X, it will also be X, because they are forming a pair of corresponding angles. They are forming a pair of corresponding angles. Correct. So we have to name it. Let us say A, B, C, D. Okay. Then E, F, G. Let's say name it. So I can say that, sir, angle ABD is equal to angle BEG is equal to X. The reason is what? They are forming a pair of corresponding angles. Okay. Now, beta, I know ki, sir, if ABD is equal to X, this BDC will also be equal to X, and this GEF will also be X, because BD and EG are angle bisectors. So I can say from here, I can say that angle DBC will also be equal to angle ABD is equal to X. Why? Because BD is angle bisector. And I can say that angle GEF is also equal to angle BEG, which is equal to X, because you can say EG is angle bisector. So after this, you can see angle ABC. What is the value of angle ABC? Angle ABC has become X plus X, which is 2X, and angle BEF has become X plus X, which is 2X. Correct. Ab beta dekhna, if you look over here, now look carefully, if you see clearly over here, to dekho beta, these two lines are given. We don't know whether they are parallel or not. But I saw that this angle ABD, which is 2X, and angle BEF, they both are equal to 2X. I can say, sir, angle ABD is equal to angle BEF, and they are forming a pair of corresponding angles. So beta, if the pair of corresponding angles are equal, I can say the lines will be parallel. So if it is true, I can say line L will be parallel to line M, and I am using converse of corresponding angle axiom. What I am using? I am using converse of corresponding angle axiom. So what I have told, ABD and BEG I have taken as X, because they have told that BD and EG are parallel. So ABD and BEG are your corresponding angles. Similarly, I know that if this BD and EG is your X, then DBC and GEF will also be equal to X, because BD and EG are angle bisector. So this angle ABD became X plus X 2X, angle BEG became X plus X 2X. Now ABC and BEF are a pair of corresponding angles. So by using the converse of corresponding angles axiom, I know that if the pair of corresponding angles formed are equal, the lines will be parallel. So I can say L will be parallel to N. You can take a screenshot. Very precisely I have written it. This way also you can write the answer. As you can see, we have written each and every reason for each and everything. Okay, okay. Let's move to the next question. The next question is this. In figure, if PQ is parallel to ST, okay, PQ is parallel to ST, where is PQ? PQ is here, ST is here, they are parallel, okay. Angle PQR is 110, angle RST is 130, find angle QRS, this angle you have to find out. Okay, the hint is given, draw a line parallel to ST through point R. So through point R, we have drawn a line XY, which is parallel to ST. Now, beta, dekho, if this XY is parallel to ST and PQ is also parallel to ST, I can say all three are parallel to each other. I can say by construction, PQ is parallel to ST is parallel to XY. Correct? So I can say that, sir, angle, this angle, which angle? This angle. Although its value is given in the diagram, but it should not be given. I can say, sir, angle QRX plus this PQR, which is 110 degree, will be equal to 180 degree. Why? Because I can say they are forming a pair of interior consecutive angles, right? So shift 110 over there. So you will get angle QRX is equal to 180 minus 110, which is 70 degree. Okay, beta? So we have got angle QRX as 70 degree over here. Similarly, here also we can find out value of this angle, angle SRY. So I can say, sir, angle SRY plus value of this angle RST, which is what, 130 degree. They both are forming a pair of interior consecutive angle. So it will be equal to 180 degree. The reason is interior consecutive angle. So I can say angle SRY is equal to 180 minus 130, which is 50 degree. Angle SRY is equal to what, beta? Angle SRY is equal to 50 degree. Okay. So this is 50, this is 70. We want to find out angle QRS. So beta, dekho, I can say that, sir, this angle QRX, plus angle QRS plus angle SRY should be equal to 180 degree. Because all of them are forming a straight angle. All of them are forming a straight angle, all three of them. So I know angle QRX is 70 plus angle QRS, I don't know, plus angle SRY is 50 is equal to 180 degree. So angle QRS will be equal to 70 plus 50 is 120. 120 shifted there, 180 minus 120 is 60 degree. Got it? So you can say angle QRS will be equal to 60 degree. Angle QRS will be equal to 60 degree. Yeah. Okay. So here it is equal, not minus, equal to 60 degree. Got it? Now let's move to the next question. In the given figure, AB is parallel to CD. Okay, sir, AB is parallel to CD. Angle BEO is 125. Angle CFO is 40 degree. Find the measure of angle EOF. Now, beta, dekho, where is angle EOF? Your angle EOF is over here. So for angle EOF, I want to find out the whole angle. So what I've done, the construction is, I have drawn a line XY passing through O. I have done one construction. draw a line XY passing through O such that XY will be parallel to AB as well as parallel to CD. All three lines are parallel to each other. All the three lines are parallel to each other. Okay. Now understand. Ki beta, first I have taken this angle EOY. You can clearly see that this angle EOY and this angle 120 degree, they both are forming a pair of interior consecutive angle. So I can say, sir, angle EOY plus 125 degree is equal to 180 degree. The reason is interior consecutive angle. Correct. So angle EOY will be equal to what? 180 minus 125, which is 55 degree. Which is what? 55 degree. After that, if you will see carefully, ki sir, this angle, angle FOY will be equal to angle OFC 40 degree. Why? Because they are a pair of what? Interior alternate angle. One is on the right side, one is on the left side, up, down. I can say, sir, angle FOY will be equal to 40 degree because they are forming a pair of interior alternate angle. So, beta, I have got this angle as 40 degree, this angle as 55 degree. So I can say, sir, angle EOF will be equal to this 55 degree plus 40 degree, which means 95 degree. So angle EOF will be equal to what, beta? It will be equal to 95 degree. Theek hai? Dekh lo, okay? Very easy part. Yeah, so you just have to think about getting the solution. The questions are very easy. Trust me. Next question. In the given figure, AB is parallel to CD is parallel to EF. If AE is perpendicular to AB, I can say AE is perpendicular to AB over here. Okay. Also, angle BAE. BAE is 90 degrees, obviously. Find the values of angle X, angle Y and angle Z. Okay, sir. We will find out. But if you take a better, first thing, if angle BAE is given as 90 degree, I can say that, sir, angle FEA, this angle FEA and this angle BAE are a pair of interior consecutive angles. See here, I am taking AC as my AE as my transversal and the line AB and the line FC as my parallel lines because all of them are parallel. Okay, so if AE is taken as transversal, these two are forming a pair of interior consecutive angle. I can say, sir, angle BAE plus angle FEA is equal to 180 degree because of interior consecutive angles. So BAE is 90 plus angle FEA is equal to 180. So you will get angle FEA is also equal to 90 degree. Although you already knew it, but I have just shown you how do you prove this part. Okay. So beta, now you have got it that this angle is 90 degree as well as this angle is also 90 degree. Now beta, I can clearly say that, sir, angle FEA is equal to 45 plus Z. They are adjacent angles. 45 plus Z because of adjacent angles. This 45 plus this angle Z. Na? So FEA is 90 is equal to 45 plus Z. So Z is equal to 45 degree. Okay, sir. Z is equal to what, beta? 45 degree. So you have got Z also as 45 degree. Now understand, if I take this CD and EF as parallel and this DE as my transversal, I can clearly say, sir, this 45 degree and this Y both are forming a pair of interior consecutive angle. So I can say, sir, this 45 degree plus angle Y should be equal to 180 degree because again they are forming a pair of interior consecutive angles. So y will be equal to 180 minus 45, which means y is equal to 135. And if y is equal to 135, you can say angle x will also be 135 because of corresponding angle. Because of what? Corresponding angle. So I can say, sir, angle x will be equal to angle y, which is equal to 135 degree, because they are forming a pair of corresponding angles. Okay, because they are forming a pair of corresponding angles. So you got to know z is 45 degree, x and y both are equal to 135 degree. Okay, so z is 45, x and y both are 135 degrees. As simple as that. Okay, now this question, look carefully. In the figure, if the line segment AB, this AB is parallel to CD. So dekho beta, this AB and CD, they both are what? They both are parallel lines. So this BD is intersecting both the lines at two different points. So BD is your transversal. So if it is transversal, look over here. This complete angle and this complete angle, these two, they are a pair of interior consecutive angles. They are a pair of interior consecutive angles. So this part is y, this part is 2y, this part is given as y, and this part is given as 5y. I can say that angle ABD will be equal to y plus 2y plus y, which is 4y, and angle CDB is given as 5y, correct? I can say angle ABD plus angle CDB is equal to 180 degree. Always write the reason, interior consecutive angles, correct? So ABD is 4y, you can write here ABD is what? 4y plus 5y is equal to 180 degree. So 9y is 180 degree. You can clearly say y will be equal to what here? Y will be equal to 20 degree. Dekh rahe ho? So easy. Y will be equal to 20 degree. Ekdam bahut easy question se beta. Just solve this part. Okay, so I want you all to start your NCERT, solve the NCERT. At least cover the whole portion before the triangles topic, angles and property of the triangles. Try to solve all the questions and let me know if you are facing any doubts. This will be your homework question. If the values are not clearly visible, I am writing it again for you. It is saying that if in the given figure L1 is parallel to L2. So this is your L1, this is your L2. What is the value of x? This angle is given as 37 degree. This angle is given as 58 degree, and here is your angle x. Okay, L1 and L2 are given parallel. One angle is 37, one angle is 58. You have to tell me what is going to be your value of x. What is going to be your value of x? Okay, beta. So this is all. I hope all of you enjoyed the session. If you have, please do not forget to like this video. Okay, so again I would like to tell you all that Vedantu Pro subscription is available to you all. You can subscribe to this by visiting the link vdnt.in/ytpro. Once you visit this link, you will get to this page where select grade 9, target CBSE 2021, click on get subscription, and you can choose from 1 month, 3 months or 6 months, anything. Okay, when it is time to pay, before paying, here na enter coupon code, apply GP Pro, Gopal Paliwal GP Pro. When you will apply this, the course fee will change from 4000 to 2699 for 1 month. You can also choose for 3 months as well as 6 months as well, and then click on buy now. Now, don't think that this is the price only for maths, as I am telling you. No, this includes the price for maths, physics, chemistry, biology, SST, all the 5 subjects of SST and your English. So it covers everything at this price. It is very cheap compared to any other tuition fee if you are giving, where you are going to study all the subjects. And as you know how master teachers of Vedantu are, so your concepts are going to be very clear. If you can afford it, I must tell you, you should definitely go for it. So in this part, you will be getting live classes,
personalized classes. Most important thing is YouTube, there is some limitations, but at Vedantu's platform, the classes can be more personalized. I will do my best over here at YouTube, but if you can afford, I must say, you should come to Vedantu's platform. Also, there you will have the chance or the choice to choose your own curriculum, because every month all the chapters will be covered through micro courses. So it is, you have a choice to choose any of the chapter. Suppose here you will tell me, sir, please complete the triangles first. Sir, please complete the quadrilaterals first. So which is not possible on YouTube. But in Vedantu's platform, if you want to study triangles first, you can go into the micro course of that. If you want to study quadrilaterals first, go into the micro course of that. So you can design your own curriculum along with a long-term batch also is available to you. Got it? And also complete crash course before the exam, test series, assignments and learning materials you will be provided with this part. Okay? So beta, this is all. I hope all of you enjoyed it. If you have enjoyed, please don't forget to give a like to this video and subscribe to this channel. Okay? And let me know any doubts if you are having. If you are having any doubts, you can reach out to me at my email ID and I will be taking those doubts in your doubt session. So try, kindly put your doubts in the comment section and let me know your answers also of the homework question in the comment section. I will take your doubts in the mentee session, before the mentee session, and your names, those who have done the homework, I will announce it in the next class. Theek hai beta? So this is all. Thank you so much. I'll see you soon in the next class. Till then, bye bye. Sayonara. Khuda hafiz.